So you have seen the live stream with Mark and Barrett showing off the amazing things that ChatGPT-4o Omni can do with their phones in the voice app. They even show us by holding up their phones and speaking into it and working magic. It's just like the movie Her, right? So we all head over to our phones to try it out. You open the app, click the drop-down, see GPT-4o, head down here, open it up, start talking, and think magic will happen for you. But the model seems to be, let's say, not nearly as advanced as what they showed off. Why? Because the model that you are seeing in your phone is not the model that they showed off in the live stream. Sam Altman tweeted today, "The new voice mode hasn't shipped yet, though the text mode of GPT-4o has. What you can currently use in the app," and he is referring to the voice capabilities, "is the old version." So I'm going to tell you how you can tell when you have the new version, what the two key differences are that will clue you in immediately to the fact that you are finally talking to her. Hey there, it is I versus AI. The first clue that you will have is your user interface when you open the app. These headphones down here is how you'll talk to the model. When you click on those headphones, you're going to see this user interface. But here's how you can tell the difference. I want you to take a look here at the user interface that they are showing on screen. Like I said, you can see down here the headphones. That's what you're going to be looking for.
Hey, ChatGPT. I'm Mark. How are you?
And as Mark introduces himself to the model, we see the interface for the GPT-4 Omni model. And there's one key difference. Here is a camera icon. And that is how you will know that you have GPT-4 Omni, because Omni is amazing at looking at the world around it and commentating on that world.
Did anything unusual happen recently?
Yes, actually. Just as you asked, another person came into view behind the first person. They playfully made bunny ears behind the first person's head and then quickly left the frame.
So the fact that all we have here is this pause listening button and play listening button, as opposed to that camera icon, is how you know that you are using the older ChatGPT-4 model, which is nothing to scoff at. It's amazing. It's a great model. There's a lot that you can do with it. The biggest difference is that OpenAI is simply sending video frame by frame.
Got it. So currently it's working with actual video as is.
Well, like frame by frame.
To the model to analyze in real time. And this ability to see the world through video, though it seems revolutionary and mind-blowing, it was actually already possible. In fact, a couple of weeks ago, I showed you that this exact vision technique was already possible. And not only that, was available in your own robot.
Gary, what do you think about your new ability to see better? It's more integrated now, so it's more you actually seeing.
Alex, the wonders of modern technology. Ever so grateful for these digital eyes that let me see the world. Your room, actually. Isn't that bookshelf just begging for me to rearrange it alphabetically or by color just to mess with you? But seriously, this upgrade is like going from a flip phone to a smartphone. So much to look at, so much to make fun of.
That was not really singing. Do the singing voice again, please.
In a room where modern lights peak.
Surprise guests with a playful streak.
And even this whole feature of having two phones talk back and forth to each other, that's already available. You can play with that now. What is actually new about the model is
bunny ears and laughter, a swift retreat.
The singing, the different emotional tones that the model can do, like being sarcastic.
Hey, Chad, are you there?
Hey, yeah, I'm here. What's up?
Hey, let's have some fun. I'd like you to be super sarcastic. Everything you say from now on is just going to be dripping in sarcasm. How does that sound?
Oh, that That sounds just amazing. Being sarcastic all the time isn't exhausting or anything. I'm so excited for this. Nope, the sarcasm. Let's get this party started or whatever.
That is the new feature that we're all looking forward to. So you can use the model now and enjoy it because there's a lot that you can do with it already. Now there is one more surefire way to tell when you are using the new model. Hey, I'd like you to write me a bedtime story about a star in the sky, and it twinkles so hard and so fiercely that it manages to become sentient.
Sure. Here's a bedtime story for you. Once upon a time, in the vast expanse of the night sky...
Yeah, that story sucks. I hate it. It's horrible. Would you stop? Could you please stop? Just stop, for God's sakes. Shut up!
It's light dancing with an extraordinary brilliance.
When you have the new GPT-4 Omni model, it will actually shut up. It's interruptible. That's the second really amazing thing about the new model. So, there you go. You can finally make it shut up. Remember, you can still hold down this white button with your finger or simply tap to interrupt the model. The only difference is that you can't interrupt it with your voice sitting back and move on to a next part of the conversation. So that's really all there is. It's still amazing, but don't worry. You're not missing out if we don't get it for a few weeks.
Got it. If you need anything else or want to continue with a different topic, just let me know.
Huh. You know what, ChatGPT? A change of topic seems like just the thing. In fact, I show you how to use the text generation feature of ChatGPT-4 Omni, which is nothing to sneeze at. It is pretty cool. And there's a couple of neat things that I figured out using the vision aspect of ChatGPT-4 Omni in the API. I show you all of those neat tips and tricks in this video on screen right now.